第三十对表演题目是 Turning Point, Education is Power, 计时开始。
Mr. Lee, I'm afraid I cannot come to class anymore.
Why? Is there anything wrong?
Because my parents, they have been arranging my marriage. They want me to marry a 40-year-old man.
What? How can a 13-year-old get married?
But it happens in our country every day. Like my cousin, she got married at the age of 11, and now she's pregnant.
So she's going to become mother?
When I saw her, I was terrified. I don't want to be like that. I don't want to be a wife and a mother. At least not now. What should I do?
Maybe you can try to tell your parents that you have learned so much at school. And if you continue to receive education, you may end up with more possibilities.
Possibilities?
Yeah.
Okay, I will try.
Where have you been? You should stay home. Soon.You are going to be married, remember?
About that, Father. Must I get married so early? I'm only 13.
What are you talking about?
But Rama, many girls in our country get married at your age. I was even younger when I got married to your father.
But that's not for me. I like to go to school and I love to learn.
School can't do any good to you. See what happens when you let her go to school.
At school, I realized that there are other possibilities. If I continue to learn, I may achieve something, just like Malala from Pakistan. And maybe I can make you proud as the sun can do.
You can make me proud now by getting married. That's it. Don't ever think about school again.
Rama, don't cry. But you know, this is our tradition. You really don't have any other choice.Just accept it.
But I do have other choice. There is only one person that can help me. Mr. Lee, I need your help.
What happened? You talked to your parents?
Yes, I did. But they still insisted. And my father even forbade me from coming to school.It is hopeless!
Don't give up. Look at this. A 10-year-old girl filed for a divorce and succeeded. Maybe we can shoot a video of your story and then upload it to the internet. Hopefully, we can draw people's attention to child marriage and make a difference. It might be risky, but are you willing to share your story with the world?
Yes, I am.
Hello, I'm Sam Lee from Taiwan. I've been working as a volunteer teacher in Yemen. 1/5 of the teenagers cannot receive education. One reason contributing to this is child marriage. Today, a potential victim is trying to tell you her own story.
I'm Rama, 13 years old. I'm arranged to get married, but I don't want to. I want to go to school and I want to learn.
This is really brave of you. What encouraged you to do this?
My teacher, Mr. Lee, told me a lot of things, including the story of Malala, a female fighter for education. I was deeply inspired and decided to stand up for myself. I hope that my story can make a change on this issue, so less girls like me can enjoy the simplicity of childhood and the pleasure of education. Thank you.
According to the survey,Girls are 6 times less likely to become child brides when they stay in school. Education can be a life-changing opportunity. Let them be girls, not brides.
Hi, Mr. Lee, I'm back.
Rama, I'm so glad to see you again. And this is
my father. Guess what?The video successfully aroused people's concern and urged the government to take legal measures against it. Many people, therefore, are greatly influenced, including my father.
Maybe education can really do something good for you. And maybe someday you can really make me proud.
I will. And Mr. Lee, I couldn't have done this without you.
Oh, I'm more than happy to see that I make a difference in people's lives. That's the reason why I'm here. Love from Taiwan.
International Volunteers, 计时开始。
Good morning! Welcome to ATJW Channel. This is Eve. I will be your host of this live show. Today, we are going to introduce you to a... Sorry. Today, we are going to introduce something about international volunteering. International volunteering is when an individual volunteers their time to work for organizations or cause outside of their home country. In most cases, volunteers work in developing countries on international development programs with local partners that address basic needs such as education, health, and sanitation. Trends show that international volunteering has become increasingly popular across many countries over the past few decades. Now, we are going to introduce you to an international volunteer, Jolene. She's a teaching volunteer in Cambodia.
Hello, my name is Jolene. I'm 18 years old, and I am an international teaching volunteer from Taiwan. I teach English, music, arts, and sports. Now, I'm going to see you how things work out in a classroom. Students, stand up, please. Let's sing and dance.
Teddy bear, teddy bear, turn around. Teddy bear, teddy bear, touch the ground. Teddy bear, teddy bear, jump up high. Teddy bear, teddy bear, touch the sky. Teddy bear, teddy bear, bend down low. Teddy bear, teddy bear, touch your toes. Teddy bear, teddy bear, turn out the light. Shh. Teddy bear, teddy bear, say good night.
Well, we can see that Jolene volunteers her specialties to children in other countries. She uses rhymes and games to make the learning more interesting and fun. Next, we are going to see Peggy, another Taiwanese girl. She's a doctor volunteer interning on a medicine and healthcare project in a developing country.
Hello everyone, I'm Peggy. I'm a senior student in medical school. I'm here in Ipoh to join the medicine and healthcare project. And I'll continue to volunteer in Ethiopia, Ghana, India, Jamaica, and Kenya. As a physical therapy intern, I'm here to help disabled children or adults to live a normal life as possible. Let me help you.
Okay.
Slowly. Slowly.
Watch out.
Slowly. Slowly. Slowly.
Wherever you travel in the world, you will always find people who love sports. Sports can bring people together and help to build strong communities, as well as contribute to the creation of healthy, happy individuals. Next, we are going to see Joy. She is a volleyball coach of International Volunteer Sports Project in Ghana.
Hello, I'm a volleyball coach from Taiwan. Volleyball is an attractive, energetic game that require a range of athletic ability, good communication, and teamwork. We think it's participating teams.
I'm here, I'm here. Give me your ball.
High five. Today, we
We've learned a lot about international volunteering. A volunteer trip abroad will change you. Change the way you see other cultures. Maybe even change how you live your life. All while you change the lives of others for the better. So, we hope everybody will join the volunteer programs. And now, we are coming to the end of our live show. I'm Eve. Hope you have a great time. Thank you for watching ATJW channel. See you next time. Goodbye.
Thank you for your watching.
第三十二队表演题目是 Water for your soul. 计时开始。
Good morning. It's 10 o'clock.And it's time for Formosa News. Despite the heavy rainfall in this season, the Central Weather Bureau warned that Taiwan might be going through its longest
drought. Such boring news again. Water is important, so we can't waste it. Such a cliche. I'm so tired of hearing the same thing again.
Well, I love rainy days. Besides, we can use as much water as we can. Hey, don't forget the water guns.There are so many water and rain here. Let's refill the water guns and make a racket!
Those kids, they know nothing about the importance of water. There is something they should learn. Hey, kids, even though there's plenty of water, you cannot waste it like that. Come here, quickly.I have something to show you.
I'm Jabari. Every day, I have to walk on bare feet for 3 hours to fetch a bucket of water. But look, the water I get is muddy.
Go beyond borders.
Inila, CNN.
This is Taiwan Television News in Africa.Although it is easy for us to have clean water, about 7 million people do not have access to clean and safe water. Luckily, with the help of World Vision, water pumps are provided for them.
I can't believe that I can have such clean water! It's so incredible!
Water crisis is never easy to be solved. However, if each of us can donate just $1 in the water project, their lives will be different.
Look at you guys! Do you still think water is something to squander?
Stop nagging!
Why do we need to worry about a problem in a different country? We're just a high school student.
Though you are just high school student, you also can make a great difference to their lives. Think about what you can do, especially you.
Hey, for the needed money.Maybe you can ask your rich parents for more money.
Your help is much appreciated, but money is not the only solution. It is your commitment that really matters.
Hey, I found some information about an annual event called World Water Day.
What is it?
World Water Day aims to solve the water crisis in underdeveloped countries with financial support.Besides, World Vision is setting up a long-term goal to help them make good use of their water resources.
A long-term goal?
How can we students in Taiwan get involved?
Joy, I know you are a frequent user of social media. Maybe you can hashtag this event on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter and spread the news out to the world.
Or better yet, you can help World Vision Taiwan to mold the idea.There's so much voluntary work you can do. Why not fill out a volunteer form now?
Sounds like a good idea.
The two students helped World Vision Taiwan spread out the news. And what they do help raise people's awareness of water crisis.
Thank you. After 10 years, a boy, Jabari, is now a backpacker who comes to Taiwan.
It's like deja vu again.
Why are you wasting water like that?
What? I just dumped the water. What's wrong with it?
There's nothing wrong about dumping water. But don't take what you have for granted. We should cherish what we have and hope one day our world will be better. Don't you know that your power, patience, knowledge can make a difference?
But how can we as an individual start?
Each of you can be the change, but it doesn't happen overnight. It might take you many years to make it happen.
I'm sure I can do it.
But what if no one listens? What if no one cares? Are you sure you can do it alone?
See, I won't do it alone. We vote to take responsibility for our future now.
That's right. In your young hearts lies the power to change the world.
Exactly. This tiny drop of water is like a drop of love. It all cleans indifference and ignorance away. You know, even a small act from you can make a huge difference.
Thank you.
首先请国立高雄师范大学英语系李翠玉教授上台讲评。
好，我们外交部的张专门委员，还有我们教育部的陈专员，还有我们几位评审老师，还有我们公示的工作伙伴，还有我们奉新高中的教育伙伴啊，还有各位参赛的老师，参赛队伍的老师同学，大家午安。大家好，我想大家很辛苦啊，在经过那么长的时间的准备哈，那今天呢是你们展现你们 power 最好的时间哈。那个人非常荣幸啊，能够参与这次的这个评审啊。那么今天呢就有我跟等一下呢这个 Stephen Olander Professor Stephen Olander 来跟大家分享我们今天整个比赛过程当中我们所观察到的几个这个给大家的建议啊。那第一个我觉得就是说参加小尖兵啊，我想对大家来说一定是一个非常非常难忘的这个经验啊，而且是一个我想在这个英语学习过程当中呢非常重要，而且呢是终身非常非常宝贵的经验。我希望大家还是请，我想先给你们的老师还有你们的这个队友自己一次的最好的鼓掌，好吧 ？Big hand！ 我相信在这里每一位。All of you are winners， 啊，这都是所谓的这个 winners 啊。那么今天不管结果怎么样哈，那都可以作为一个非常好的自己在英语学习上面的一个参考啊。那么当然作为老师呢，我们这个就会有一些就作为评审，我们会有一些这个专业上面的一些考量啊，那提供给大家做参考啊。那第一个就是说因为英文老师我们注意到的当然是英语的能力啊，发音的问题啊，所以我们看到有很多同学呢就是还是非常很基本的一些问题啊，比如说包括我们几位老师也观察到的那种所谓的 long vowels 啊，这种长母音的这种念法啊，就是说大家要知道，就是说既然你到台上来啊，你的这个 delivery 你要更清楚啊，虽然你这个在念啊，可是在念英文的时候，你要把很多很多的母音啊，要念清，你的这个 articulate 要更清楚啊。那么还比如说，包括我们这个注意到了一些音哈，比如说像 the world， 好 the world， 还有一些 low vowels 的这样的一个问题，还有比如说。Beach， 大家知道那个 beach 这个音要发的非常非常的要注意哈，因为一旦这个念的不够长的话，或者这个的话，你就会这个会有一些 misunderstanding， 对不对？然后还有一些很基本的问题，我想大家在平常一定都知道，可是当你上台念的时候，或者是你的剧本在念的时候，可能就要特别注意啊，比如说像children， 你不能这个 one children。有没有 one children？ 没有，对不对？好 ，children 是本身就是一个复数型嘛，哈，所以要特别注意这些这样的问题啊。 那么另外就是说，我们也注意到，就是呢，你在念的时候，其实不是 reading 啊，这边不是在 test your，you know，how much do you remember，you know，your memorization， 不是啊。所以你在念的时候，千万不要this time you won't be alone，this time you won't be alone。还有呢，比如说像什么。This is a little invention which can change. A little invention can change the world. 大家想想看，你要 change the world. 好，当你用一个很平淡的或者是很快念过去的这样的速度的时候，你就不会期待你的 audience 去感染到你。你真的是希望你的那个 message 是要 change the world 那样的一个 power， 对不对？好，所以大家可能要注意到，就是说，当你在念这个 presentation 的时候，你不是只是一个像我们平常这样 read the lines 啊，你是一个 performance 啊， you're supposed to present your lines， you know， with clarity。那你可能还要特别注意的，就是说你要找到 find out the stress 啊 stress， you know, not only stress for a singular。For one single word 或者是怎么样 pronunciation， 而是你整个一个 line 当中哪些东西是要你去加强的啊？你可能要稍微要去思考一下哈，那要找到那个所谓的 tempo 啊，而不是呢用一种很平铺直述的一种方式来说哈。那第二个部分，我觉得呢，就是说，既然这是一个 performance， 这是一个 presentation， you're supposed to entertain。Your audience, right? You entertain your audience. 你要想想看，你是在表演给别人看，对？你是希望试着让 audience 能够感染到你这个剧，你要去 get the meaning 啊。对 audience 来说，所以你随时随地呢都要 keep your audience in mind 啊。那你要我希望就是说，大家既然在台上，你还是要 enjoy， 对不对？好 ，enjoy， 千万不要非常非常的这个但 stage fright， 我想这个大家都很难避免啊。可是基本上你可以学着、就是稍微relax 一下啊，然后 enjoy your performance。那么另外呢，我想就几个部分来跟大家做分享啊，就是在舞台上面的一些所谓的表演的效果啊，就是我观察到，就是说基本上大家都会利用一些所谓的道具哈、布景啊。那么我个人认为，就是说这些布景的这些使用呢，可能是要思考，就是说有些东西呢是要很适度的来使用啊，它不会干扰到你的整个 performance。比如说我们看到有一些这个 props 呢，它其实是你已经是放反了，好，它那个字呢本身就是一个 upside down 啊，是放反的啊，你可能都没有注意到。那么另外还有，比如说有些字呢，可能不是那么，可能太小，那太小的话，对后面的观众来说呢，就不是那么 visible， 啊，不是那么明显啊，不是那么很清楚可以看得见啊。那么另外还有就是说，希望大家搬道具的时候呢。搬道具的时候啊，千万不要太吵哈，太吵，你要学着默默的哈，就把道具搬好，因为那样的这些 noises 可能会是一些所谓的干扰。那这些当然虽然是说起来是很 minor 的事情啊，可是我想既然大家学到就是这是这个所谓 stage performance 一个 presentation 啊，有些很基本的一些技术上面的一些要注意的细节呢，可能要请大家要在这个注意哈。那另外就这个 topic 上面来说哈，我想提供给大家做一些这个参考，就是说我们今天的 topic 叫做 to make a difference。You know, for me, that you know, you have to clarify. Well, when it comes to the topic like this, you have to first of all define, right? What define its meaning? Define what it means by saying, how to make a difference. What difference? What difference? You know, do you mean and do you refer to? 是什么样的一个所谓的 difference you're talking about? 对，那还有 to make a difference. 大家要注意到 to make 是一个方法，对不对？你一定要讲到 how to 啊，你一定要 address in order to address the topic. I think these things are things that you have to have in mind. 好，这些都是你要注意到的哈。那么，所以 比如说你在这个讲到这个题目的时候，你可能要更清楚的来讲，就是说现在的年轻人呢，你怎么样去 participate 啊，国际的参与 participate in the international community 这一部分，可能是我当我在看到这个题目的时候，我希望你在回答这个问题的时候能够去展现的。那么另外就是我发觉就是好几个队伍呢，可能都多多少少都会有这样的问题啊，就是说还是会我们有看到那种所谓 stereotyping 啊 ，cultural stereotyping 太过于很多的刻板印象啊，比如说非洲 Africa is always depicted as a backward, you know, uncivilized, you know, place 哈、啊，就是非洲好像都永远是那种落后的哈、啊，这个不现代的这样的一个地方哈、啊，而且很多人非洲啊，我们评审老师有讲到，非洲其实很大。啊、非洲它有很多很多的 you know, diversity、啊、它有很多的多元性、啊、可能不是我们很简单的很化约的只是想 OK 非洲就是那个地方，台湾是怎么样，非洲是怎么样、啊、我希望大家可能要再多做一点更功课、啊、特别是不要太有这种所谓的 superiority、啊、太多的所谓的很优越感的、啊、好像我们就是去 help我们去 civilize 哈，我们去做什么样去 modernize 啊，这些地方哈，其实可以换一个角度来想啊，就做volunteering 啊，我想很多队伍都讲到 volunteering， 从 volunteering 当中，我们其实反而是一种学习，我们跟他们学习，而不是说我们一定是永远是付出的啊，或者是我们是施恩给 patronize 啊，给其他国家的那一方哈。那么那么另外呢，我也这个最后我也提出一个建议啊，就是说当你一个剧本出来的时候呢，我希望大家在展现的时候可以再思考啊，既然只有五分钟的时间啊，你的 opening 要怎么样，你的 ending 要怎么样啊，你要让大家感觉你是一个一气呵成的，你是一个特别是你的刚开始你的结束啊，都是要有一个 strong opening， 要一个 strong finish， 要一个很完美的结束啊，让大家感觉 OK， 大家的这个所有的观众呢是随着你的这个剧情的这个起伏，我都没有办法一秒都不会扎哈，我完全都是 very much into your show， into your presentation 啊，我想这样子的话呢。这个大家会做得更好啊。那么再一次呢，我想再一次的恭喜大家哈，完成这一次的任务。那我们也期待大家，我也相信大家在未来的这个英语学习或者是在参与这个所谓国际事务当中呢，会有更好、更大的成就。好，谢谢大家。
接着请国立高雄师范大学英语系欧思迪教授上台讲评。
Okay, thank you for inviting me, and I thought some of your plays were quite inventive, you know, 发明的 quite inventive, innovative, creative, imaginative, good pace,not too slow. Of course, you only had, what, 5 minutes or so, right? So you had to go pretty quickly, didn't you? And colorful, with a lot of haibao, you know, a lot of posters. Some of them were quite delightful to look at, right? And it gives you a sense of the setting, right? Puts you in the setting. As for criticisms, when I see a play, I look for realism. In other words,does it seem real, like these people are not just actors, but they're people who are really involved in this situation, right? And therefore, I like to see, gestures, like, what do you say, soji? Gestures which are not too exaggerated, but seem like they areThe way people would move and speak in that situation. And therefore, I like to see people look at each other when they're talking to each other, not looking ahead at the audience. When they're talking, they're supposed to be talking to each other, right? So they face each other, look at each other, respond to each other, right? when you're talking to the audience, okay, then you could face the audience like I'm doing now, right? But otherwise, I think you should look at and speak to the other students on stage. Now, as far as English, your use of English, yeah, there were some mistakes. One of you, one common mistake is the pronunciation of moon, which is always too short. When I hear it, a lot of people say moon instead of moon. And so remember that, spoon, moon, soon, right? So you have to make sure you have a very long O. And somebody said, I think so funny, instead of a lot of fun. You know, so funny is hao xiao, right? And a lot of fun is hao wan. So make sure you distinguish between the two. And somebody said, if I were him. Well, you really should say, if I were he, right? Because of bi dong zi. However, I will tell you that a lot of Americans would say, if I were him. So don't feel bad if you said, if I were him. Now, as far as your topics and themes, I recommend you do more research. You have the web at your disposal, right? And try to find the cause of certain problems in the world and good solutions for them, right? And then you could be more specific rather than and so general, right? Of course, one problem in Africa, for example, is the governments don't want people coming in and helping the population because they control the population by keeping them hungry. It's terrible, but that's what they do, right? So a lot of times the situation is not as simple as it seems, right? And the same, you can say the same for, you know, girl marriages at 13, the same for water, the water problem, right? The water problem, one big problem with water is big companies, Western companies go in and use a lot of the water, and the people don't have enough water to drink. One such company is Kalu, you know, Coca-Cola. They use a lot of water in their manufacturing of the drink, and they get this water from local resources of whichever country they're in, of course, right? And as far as going and helping people, of course, somebody, I think, said we taught them to fish. Right, rather than giving them fish, you know, you give a man a fish, he has enough for a day. You teach him to fish, he has enough for a lifetime. That's the idea, right? And another way of saying it is you help people help themselves, right? Help them help themselves. But you have to remember that when you are helping people, first of all, do they want to be helped? Do they want to be helped? Some people don't want to be helped. They'd rather do it themselves. And if you do help them, you should let them do as much as they can themselves. Then they retain their dignity, you know? They retain their self-respect that way, see? And you should not pretend to know everything, and they don't know anything, you see? In other words, don't pretend to be superior to them, because in their environment, you probably will not be superior to them. In fact, I would say you will not. Because they know how to survive in their environment better than you do, just as you know how to survive in your environment better than they do, you see. And also you should gauge their attitude toward your service, right? Because do they appreciate, for example, what you're doing for them? If they don't appreciate it, then it may be because they don't really want to be helped, you see. And so in other words, don't assume that you know everything and they know nothing, right? Is another way of saying it. This is the same for, this relates to this problem of, and also you should listen to their ideas about things. They may have very good ideas about their problems and solutions, right? And this relates to the problem of the Syrian refugees. The Syrian refugees, Oh, this is a big problem because some of them are really refugees. They seek asylum or some kind of safe harbor from a war-torn country, right? But some of them are just opportunists. In other words, they want a bigger handout. So in other words, they are going to countries that will give them more. They don't want to stay in countries that give them less. So in other words, it's just, as we call opportunism, they want to take advantage of every opportunity, right? Of course, this money that they're getting comes from the people, right, of that country, right? So do the people, should the people give them more money when they just want a handout or a bigger piece of the pie, you might say? Of course, I would not. If I were living in that country, I would want them to get jobs and support themselves. Of course, they may need help temporarily. That's okay. But some of them also may have diseases. So do you want people with diseases coming into your country and spreading diseases? And some of them may be terrorists also, Kongbu Fanzi, right? Because the terrorist organizations have even boasted or said that they plan on infiltrating, you know, or joining these groups in order to penetrate the borders or enter the country, right? So, and another problem is some of them do not wish to adapt to the local customs. They want to live the life that they live or follow the customs that they followed in their own country, you see? But you know the rule. When in Rome, you do as the Romans do. You don't expect the Romans to do as you do, right? So this is a big problem. Some people really deserve help and need help, others do not. And of course, what the government should do is screen these people and find out who is who and who really deserves help and who doesn't and who should be invited to stay and who not. And thank you very much. That's the end.
现在，请外交部公众外交协调会张进旺专门委员上台为我们揭晓晋级名单。
各位老师、各位同学，大家好哈！像我早上讲的，这个不论晋级或者是没有晋级，你们的程度比远远比一般的高中的这个学生的英文能力高出太多了。所以今天不论是有没有晋级哈，各位都是永远的外交小尖兵。那么各位也担负起未来跟国际接轨的任务。那么希望未来到大学，我们外交部也协助大家担任这个国际青年大使。各位也能够继续跟政府一起，然后去做外交的打拼，或者是你大学毕业之后想去海外做这个度假打工，我们部里面也有这样的政策来辅导。那么再一次感谢各位的参加，那我今天就来宣布，这晋级了16个队伍，第一队是，五号，再来是七号，十号，十二号，十四号，十五号。16号，17号，18号，21号，22号，23号，24号，26号，28号，最后一个，恭喜了，30号。好，恭喜大家，再次恭喜。那各位努力，加油！大家都是外交小尖兵，谢谢各位，谢谢。
第30队演讲题目是 Number 4，计时开始。
Good morning, dear judges. With this opportunity to introduce our country.We're going to present our features with its own name, T-A-I-W-A-N, Taiwan. T is for diverse terrains. Taiwan is an island situated in East Asia. It is a tilted fault block, characterized by the contrast between eastern two-thirds, consisting mostly of five rugged mountains ranges parallel to the east coast, and the flat to gently rolling plain of the western part, on which most of Taiwan's population resides. Among several lofty mountains, the nearly 4,000-meter Yushan, which is about 13,000 feet high, makes Taiwan the fourth highest island in the world.
A is for tourist attractions. Taiwan's beautiful scenery and various festivities make numerous destinations worth visiting. Take Taroko National Park, for example. Located in the eastern Taiwan, Taroko National Park is one of the nine national parks of Taiwan. Its majestic gorges, magnificent cliffs, valleys, and romantic waterfalls make this place a landscape painting of mountains. On the other hand, Penghu, as an archipelago dotting over the Taiwan Strait, attracts tourists at home and abroad by its crystal clear ocean, white sandy beaches, unique rocky formation, and historic sites featuring collective memories of local people. Besides tasty seafood all year around, the firework festival there is held annually to provide visitors with an additional entertainment. I is for technology industry. Information technology industry in Taiwan has played a dominant role in the global IT field over the last two decades. With the government's focus on expertise development, along with marketing and management strategies, world-famous companies such as ASUS and Acer were hence established. Members of this industry, with its experience and resources, closely cooperate with major international suppliers, making Taiwan the leading hub of the Asia-Pacific region.
W is for warmth from its people. Hospitable warmth of Taiwanese is always impressive. A Singaporean writer once drew a contrast between people in Taiwan and Singapore through a simple poster he saw in a Taipei restaurant, which read, "Please excuse us for being short of helping hands, short of greetings, and short of smiles." It may sound normal to Taiwanese, while in Singapore, they have similar signs saying things like, "Please help yourselves when we are busy." See, the difference in the tone shows the hospitality and human warmth of Taiwanese. A is for artistry. The best thing about experiencing the endless variety of art forms is that whatever you like, everything ranging from traditional skills to modern arts is right at hand. Glove puppetry, for example, as a performing art symbolic of Taiwanese, incorporates music, literature, and voice acting. Taiwanese opera, on the other hand, with thoughts, feelings, and aesthetics, infuses new elements and remains a favorite folk art in Taiwan.
N is vulnerability. People in Taiwan enjoy the good reputation for our concern and sympathy for people in despair. Whenever a disaster strikes, we Taiwanese are more than willing to come to others' assistance. Specifically, renowned is that when Japan was hit by the tsunami 4 years ago, people on this island gave a helping hand to the victims without delay. Supplies and funds poured from every corner of Taiwan to the tsunami-stricken areas, with donations worth $6 billion, surpassing that from other countries. With all the characteristics mentioned above, we can conclude that Taiwan, such a beautiful country with its lovely people, is definitely worthy of a visit. Come to this fantastic island and experience its beauty and vitality on your own.
Number 4, 计时开始。Good
morning, ladies and gentlemen. More and more countries provide visa-free courtesies or landing visas to Taiwan's nationals. 7 years ago, there were only 54 countries. Now, ROC passport has truly come up in the world. we have won our ticket of admission to Taiwan's international relations. Most importantly, the policy brings positive effects to Taiwan's people in our international relations. Now, my partners are going to show you our view. First, Carol will give you the first viewpoint, the freedom to travel around the world and the promotion of Taiwan's international status. Welcome to Carol.
Thank you, Bella. First, the freedom to travel around the world represents the promotion of Taiwan's international status. With visa-free courtesies, travelers from Taiwan need only pack their bags, buy an airplane ticket, and take off. The key factor to get up and go overseas is not the availability of airline tickets and hotel rooms, but the visa-free entry. For example, visa approval procedures in the US became quite strict after the 911 terrorist attack. In Taiwan, applying for a visa needs filling out an interminable English application form, paying a visa fee of $4,880, going for an interview and waiting for an approval. Now, in contrast, one needs to only go online and obtains an electronic travel authorization. However, convenience and money saved is not the only benefits of the visa-free courtesies. In fact, such courtesies enhance Taiwan's status in the international community. Next, Jane will give you another viewpoint.
Thank you, Carol. Visa-free courtesies can cooperation and boost economic growth. Due to globalization, tourism drives economic growth and employment. While American President Obama was seeking re-election, the White House hoped to get an immediate economic stimulus. Therefore, Taiwan was admitted to U.S. visa waiver program. In fact, only 37 nations were admitted to this VWP. The threshold for inclusion is quite high. These countries maintain high status for dealing with illegal immigration, passport forgery, and border control. Since Taiwan has no official tie with the US, Taiwan's admission shows that ROC has joined this lag group. Most importantly, the US sees Taiwan as a safe and high quality place. That is, Taiwan's people won't use tourism as excuse to flee to a state. Finally, my partner Andy will give you our last viewpoint, the three lines of defenses and security cooperation.
Thank you, Jen. Last but not least, Taiwan's inclusion in the VWP stands as a major success for President Ma's pursuit of cross-strait relationship peace. The U.S. has been Taiwan's most important diplomatic ally and trading partner for the past 60 years. Taiwan's admission to the VWP shows that the mainland accepted the three lines of defense and that we are both competitive and cooperative within the cross-strait relation peace. That is, when it comes to a direct impact on the interests of ordinary people, the mainland is not likely to raise a fuss. Now, Bella, we'll make a conclusion.
All in all, with visa-free courtesies or landing visas, Taiwan's travelers can move freely around the world and are well treated. Most importantly, Taiwan business people can fly over the globe and create Taiwan's economic miracle without the hassle of applying for a visa. In addition to the convenience of visa-free travel, Taiwan's people is also benefit from indirect official protection. Taiwan is honored with the unique international status. We believe that this not only shows our international relations, but also proves Taiwan society safe. Thank you for your attention.
The 26th演讲题目是 Number 2. 计时开始.
Good morning, honorable judges. Today, we are going to talk about topic number 2. Traveling can be a nightmare for those on restricted passports. Luckily, holding an ROC passport, we have visa-free, e-visa, or even landing visa access to more than 150 countries. A list compiled by passportindex.org shows that Taiwan is ranked the 28th most powerful passport in the world. This signifies not only that Taiwanese people have more freedom to travel around the world, but also that Taiwan has strengthened its standing in the global community. Now, Hans will illustrate the freedom that Taiwanese people have.
For individuals, having visa-free, e-visa, or landing visa privileges means that there will be less hassle and fewer bureaucratic procedures involved in traveling. It also means that we can visit several countries in one trip. Imagine if we don't have such privileges, and if we want to see more countries in Europe, then we have to apply for different visas in advance, which is time-consuming and costly. The best of all, these privileges apply to every Taiwanese citizen, whether you are a legislator or a high school student. On the contrary, if you hold a restrictive passport, you may have your right to travel regardless of your background or profession. Now, Lydia will talk about the significance of this policy for our international image.
Taiwan's standing in the global community is strengthened again this year when six nations and territories, including India and Iran, extended visa-free, e-visa, or landing visa privileges to our citizens. Compared with the least powerful passports in the world, namely Afghanistan, Iraq, Somalia, and Pakistan, we can see immediately that Taiwan presents an image of a stable political environment to the world. In addition, the fact that Taiwanese people are welcomed with open arms in other countries is a testament that our good social services and our stable economy make it less likely for Taiwanese travelers to become illegal immigrants. According to Professor Eric Neumeier of the London School of Economics, the poorer, the less democratic, and the more exposed to armed political conflict the target country is, the more likely the visa restrictions are in place against its visa holders. Enjoying these privileges definitely recognizes Taiwan's standing in the global community. Now, Isabel is going to tell us the significance of Taiwan's international relations.
Given that Taiwan is now a member of the United Nations, having visa-free, e-visa, or landing visas access to over 150 countries displays the good relationship we have with other countries. The most powerful passport holders are mostly the countries that are economically and politically strong, like the United States and the United Kingdom. It is no surprise that other countries want to keep good terms with them. Even though we are not the most powerful or the wealthiest country, our compassion and humanitarian aid we provide allow us to maintain a good relationship with the rest of the world. This suggests that our effort have turned into international influence and has been recognized internationally. Now, Kevin will conclude our discussion.
The result speaks volumes. We are very blessed for being able to travel as a citizen of Taiwan. Our passport shows that we have a positive international image and that we have fairly good international relations across the world. Taiwan is definitely a citizen of this global village, and we believe that together we can make the difference.
Wow, thank you.
第24段演讲题目是 Number 5, 计时开始.
Good morning, judges. Our topic is the importance to develop a global perspective and elaborate ways to develop a global perspective without needing to spend lots of money. German philosopher Arthur Schopenhauer observed, every person takes the limit of their vision for the limits of the world, and Albert Einstein advised, we cannot solve our problems with the same thinking we used, when we created them. This is especially true for today, since we are living in a global village, where the whole world is closely connected and closely interdependent. Therefore, it is important for us to expand our vision toward a global perspective. A global perspective will help us better understand other people's views and get us to be more tolerant and respectful. Hopefully, this will bring about a better world.
One way to develop a global perspective is by participating in the Model United Nations. The Model United Nations, abbreviated to MUN, is an educational simulation in which students learn about diplomacy, international relations, and the United Nations. More importantly, students learn about the world as they prepare for MUN group discussions, represent one country other than their own, and present possible solutions to the whole committee. I have been in the Model United Nations for 3 years, and while attending MUN conferences, I have played the role of the delegate, representing one country other than to the international body, articulating its positions. In order to write a position paper, I have to do research on geography, culture, economy, and even the politics of that one particular country. By doing such research, I gained an in-depth insight into countries such as Philippines, Indonesia, and some other countries that I have never been to. This indeed has expanded my reach globally.
Interacting with foreigners, in my opinion, is an even better and more economical way to develop a global perspective. Taiwan is an international country. There are an increasing number of exchange students coming from different parts of the world to Taiwan, which means that we have more chances to interact with foreigners. By interacting with foreigners, we can literally experience different perspectives from different cultures, and thereby broaden our horizons. Take myself for example. I enjoy exchanging ideas with people from different countries on certain issues. Once, I talked with some exchange students from Europe about the issue of green energy. They told me that some houses in Europe are built with recyclable materials and that they are proud to have a solar energy system to help ease the worsening global warming problem. Through this conversation, I learned that green energy in Europe is more progressive than Taiwan, and that green life is not only a governmental policy, but it can be a lifestyle. This conversation not only opened my eyes, but also raised my awareness to environmental issues.
On top of the above mentioned ways, interactive online news also plays an essential role in developing global perspective. With advanced technology, getting information about the world is just a click away. Furthermore, the interactive functions allow readers to have an open discussion with foreigners, which also helps foster critical thinking, cultivating global perspective. Newton once said, "If I had seen further, it is by standing on the shoulders of giants." However, we do not necessarily have to climb up onto a giant's shoulder to perceive the world in a broader view. What we can do is to exchange ideas with foreigners, either in person or online, and put ourselves in other people's shoes. That way, we can truly see the world from other people's eyes and thereby develop global perspective without needing to spend a lot of money. Thank you.
第23对演讲题目是 Number 1, 计时开始.
Good morning, ladies, gentlemen, and all the guests. Today, we will talk about humanity. Since World War II,
human rights have become a visible problem. As we know, the quick development of technology has sped up globalization in the world. For example, Taiwan has offered medical help, food aid, technology resources to many countries, like Ethiopia, Burkina Faso, and so on. Besides, not only the government, but also companies have launched a lot of activities that aim at saving the poor and bring them a better environment. So they don't need to worry about wars and diseases. Moreover, there are still many volunteer workers making efforts to make this world full of harmony and happiness instead of wars and griefs.
Undoubtedly, the sense of helping has been rooted in many people's minds in Taiwan. For example, when a terrible earthquake hit Japan on March 11, 2011, Taiwan sent salvage crops to Japan at once, providing not only long-term but also short-term financial aid. Meanwhile, non-governmental organizations in our country encouraged people to contribute our own power to help those who were serving in other countries. Being a teenager, although we do not have much money, we have time. Although we can spend either our summer vacation or winter vacation to contribute our own power.
30RFM is another example to show humanitarian aid. World Vision Taiwan has held the 30RFM since 1990. It is a concept about praying in silence and hunger. The main idea is to help the world which suffers from natural disaster by collecting the resources throughout the world and support these countries building up their home again. For around 25 years, this activity has helped the victims of the 2004 earthquake and tsunami, the 2011 Great East Japan earthquake, and the Syrian Civil War. As teenagers, participation in 30RFM is a direct and simple way to care for the world. By joining this activity, we can experience the exhaustion of food and water on our own, which makes us bring ourselves in others' shoes. This activity has brought the entire world together to make our society a better one. Also, we will appreciate what we have after we really understand the suffering of others. If time permits, we can be a host or a member of staff, persuading others to donate their love to the world.
Being teenagers, in addition to financial support, there is still something we can do to care about the world. For example, conserving the money we spend on entertainment and donate land to those in need. Second, we can also donate our courses, books to charities that really help the poor who have no books to read. Moreover, I believe the small action we do today will someday influence the whole world. As the saying goes, particles of sand accumulated form a towering pile. Maybe we can do great things for the world, but small things with great love. I truly believe that what we teenagers do today will someday build a tower that we can help all the poor in the world from we, teenagers in Taiwan. Here comes to the end of our presentation.
Wow, thank you.
第22队演讲题目是 Number 1, 计时开始。
Good morning, dear judges. In recent year, Taiwan has helped many countries. For example, the World Vision Taiwan All Help Reserve has held 30-hour famines for a long time. These activities led Taiwan's people to enjoy it. But
they left Taiwan's people hungry because then that Taiwan's people feel the sense of hunger and call on Taiwan's people to donate money for the victims in the foreign country. These activities not only make Taiwan people experience the sense of hunger, but also make large sum of money for foreign country and help many poor children and victims.
The other example is that there is a famous association in Taiwan. It is called Taiwan Road Medical Association. They had for not only in the village in mountain, but also the countries which are in lack of medical resource. They go abroad to give medical rescue for free once 2 months. They pay their help to others not only when disaster happened, but also in the ordinary.
We might think we pay much to other people, but actually the receipts we get from them are far beyond our imaginations. For instance, tsunamis happened in Japanese years ago. Taiwanese came to their rescue immediately. So, when disaster happened in Taiwan, they came to help us too.
Though we are junior high school students, we don't have large sums of money. We only have limited power, but we can't stop our behavior. Because we gather our power, it will make a bigger energy. We have attended the 30 hunger famine. By doing this, I experienced what the real hunger is. And also we donate some money, although this is a small step of ours, but I believe it will be a big step of them. Actions speak louder than words. We can't just plan it and say it. We have to do it. So we can collect some books or secondhand clothes and send them to someone they need. By doing this, I believe we can not only make our country be bigger and more powerful, we can help others. They can make country and country relationship more stable. I believe we do this, we are ordinary people, but we can do something out of ordinary.
Thank you. 第21队演讲题目是 Number 4, 计时开始。
Today I would like to introduce Taiwan. I come from Taiwan, also called Formosa in the past. It is a beautiful island with abundant resources. Although it is a small country in Asia, the population here is around 24 million, making it a competitive and advanced country with many excellent people. Therefore, if you have a chance to visit Taiwan, you can find many fresh and creative things here. Because of its geographical location and conditions, my My country also has many beautiful attractions for people to visit. There are many popular tourist sites in Taiwan. The first one I would like to introduce is Taipei 101. It is the tallest building in my country. If you want to get a view of our capital, Taipei, you can take its fattest elevators to the observation deck. You also can go shopping with your friend there.
If you feel like getting close to nature, there are also many nice places to choose in our country, such as National Alley Mountain Scenic Area or Taroko Park. You can get to know more about Aboriginal cultures and enjoy the magnificent scenes there. If you enjoy getting suntans on the beach, then Kandin is your best choice. The beaches in Kandin are very attractive. There are also many special shops around the beach, selling unique handmade shelled windbells or other stuffs. The National Museum of Marine Biology and Aquarium in Kandin is also deserve a visit because it has a variety of fish species.
My country is also famous for its local food. When it comes to the food in Taiwan, tourists will never miss the chance to go to the night markets. Here, I would like to introduce you some special food you can find in almost every night market in Taiwan. Oyster omelets, stinky tofu, bubble tea, and papaya milk are the snacks and drinks you can find in almost every night market in Taiwan. The reason why they are so popular is because the specialty and the delicious taste. Take stinky tofu, for example. When you first take it for the first time, you'll be disgusting with a pungent smell. But after tasting it, you'll feel it is quite different from what you think. It is very tasty. And if you have the courage and chance to try it, you will be deeply fond of it. Bubble tea is also worth a try. It is also called pearl milk tea. The pearl or bubble are made of tapioca. And when it is, it will be quite chewy when you boil it and cool it in syrup. Then mix it with milk and black tea. You'll find the flavor is a perfect match.
Besides scenic spots and delicious food, Taiwan is also famous for its human kindness. Taiwanese are very kind and friendly. If you walk on the street and need help, you are bound to meet many strangers who are willing to give you a hand. Their English may not be as good as the native English speakers. However, they will try their best to understand you and offer their help. Therefore, if you are also willing to know more about my country, welcome to take a trip with me to my country. Then I will be a fantastic tour guide. Then you can experience our country, the colorful and wonderful Taiwan.
Good morning. Today, we are going to talk about humanitarian activities.
According to President Ma, Taiwan has committed to being part of the international community through humanitarian efforts. For example, the Taiwanese rescue teams and crew members have traveled across the Pacific Ocean to deliver medical supplies and relief goods to Haiti after it was struck by a deadly earthquake on January 12. In addition, Taiwan had offered humanitarian assistance to Japan in 2011 after the Tohoku earthquake and tsunami. What's more, Taiwan is dedicated to dealing with the shortage of education and carrying out environmental protection in the international community.
In my opinion, speaking of humanitarian aid,
we young people can do a lot of meaningful things to get involved in this work. First of all, we can help those in need as volunteers. For example, last summer, we had a fortunate opportunity to be volunteers in Thailand, where lots of children don't have access to receiving proper education. Despite the poor environment, we found the children there eager to learn. Therefore, we read to them, told them some basic Chinese, and even helped them cleaning and repairing their houses. We really had a good time learning and playing with the kids. The friendship we developed were meaningful because the thing we were engaged in was meaningful. And in the end, we held each other and cried. In addition to volunteer work, we young people have the opportunity to be involved in some of Taiwan's humanitarian activities, such as 30 Hours Famine held by World Vision. This program raises awareness about world hunger through having its participants go without food for 30 hours, that they can have compassion on those who suffer from starvation. And we can learn an experience about society's serious issues, like poverty and injustice. In this way, we can learn a real difference from hungry children.
Another great program that brings us closer together as a global community is international adoption. There are many poor children leading poor lives in very bad conditions. So it only makes sense to us that we invite them into our hearts and homes and families that they may enjoy the conditions we enjoy every day, like clean water and adequate education. For those not looking to expand their families, we can donate things like clothing or books, or even more importantly, our times. And in this way, people like us, small high school students, can make a significant contribution on a world stage.
The 17队演讲题目是 Number 1, 计时开始。
Even in recent years, there has been a number of people suffering from hunger, floods, drought, horrible diseases, and other natural and man-made disasters. But there are always people who give unconditionally in the name of love and care. Humanitarian aid is one way that brings this globalized world together. Honorable judges, ladies and gentlemen, how can Taiwan help and make the most of our abilities and strengths? What roles are there for teenagers to play? Now, let's hear from Ernie for an inspiring story.
As teenagers, how can we be the helping hands for people in need? There was a girl named Chen Huijie, and when she was only 8 years old, she was already volunteering to pack up lunch boxes for elderly people who lived alone. But after reading an article about the hunger issue in East Africa at the age of 9, she realized that she needed to take this a step further. She started holding various fundraising concerts for the next 3 years, raising over 50,000 NT dollars to buy about 2,000 tons of rice for children in Africa. She also started the 30-hour famine event, where she linked 3 high schools to join her and surpass what she had accomplished before. At such a young age, she could only accomplish such things by having a kind heart and a tenacity that proves what teenagers can do is unlimited. As the saying goes, let no man despise your youth. As long as we have the heart, we can accomplish anything and be the helping hands for those in need. Now, let's hear from April to talk about a Taiwanese girl who devoted herself to helping orphans in undeveloped countries.
At the age of 12, Chen Luoxiao began her incredible life of helping and caring for the needy. From visiting orphanages and nursing homes, raising funds on the streets to becoming an international volunteer, Chen Luoxiao promised that she would spread her love across the globe. In 2008, Chen Luoxiao became a volunteer in Ethiopia, where she dedicated her life to taking care of orphans as if they were her own children. In 2010, a ferocious earthquake struck Haiti, resulting in more than 300,000 deaths. Additionally, statistics showed a dramatic 10 times increase of the orphaned, and so she flew there immediately. She then launched a project, Foundation Infant Jesus, and continued volunteering in Haiti and the Dominican Republic. We don't have to be rich in order to help others. As long as we truly care, we can make a difference. Now, let's hear from Jennifer to talk about how Taiwanese youth take part in humanitarian affairs.
All across the world, people come together and organize groups to help provide for the homeless, hungry, and others in need. One such group is YES, known as the Youth E-Service, which was founded by a few Taiwanese college students in 2003. Starting from local community service, they began to widen their reach into foreign countries. In recent years, they've been holding a variety of activities in small villages in Thailand and Myanmar, assisting the destitute and homeless people suffering the effects of war and disease. One of their group leaders, Zhang Li'an, said, "The small work we did is the way to elevate their lives and open up their eyes to the international kingdom, leading them to our globalized world. By taking part in these efforts, we continue a great paradigm in humanitarian aid. We have taken large steps in volunteering and charity work, and all of these actions have the potential to greatly benefit other people's lives. Through the spirit of humanitarian aid, Taiwanese youth can truly show the entire world the effort and passion we can offer."
From Taiwanese teenagers to nonprofit organizations, we are all important performers on the international stage. There are young Taiwanese lives who are willing to dedicate their strength and effort to help others. At the same time,
powerful and influential MPOs
devote their minds to the goal of assisting those who are in need.
Humanitarianism plays a crucial role in saving lives,
and in which Taiwanese teenagers
will surely take a role
that can be continually improved as the
lessons of love and care are learned and applied.
第16队演讲题目是 Number 4, 计时开始。
Good morning, judges, ladies and gentlemen. Our topic is number 4. We will talk about some creative ways to introduce Taiwan if we had the chance to travel overseas and interact with local students.
To reach the goal, we propose utilizing another way to let people know Taiwan and come to Taiwan. There are two solutions we concluded, and they will be shown as the followings. The first one is drama, and the other is music.
Thanks, Ian. First, I believe drama is the best to show Taiwanese great power in culture cultivation. We take the experience of the most established Taiwanese opera, Minghua Yuan, as an example. Minghua Yuan had ever made a series of performances to the countries in Africa. And it not only raised the audience's eyebrows, but also got a good press. The French Top First News, Le Figaro, adored it, the alternative sound of Taiwan. Moreover, the third prince of Taoism, Nessa Stance, which is known for its traditional music mixed with electric popular songs. The performers are in traditional costumes, but dancing with lively and rakish dancing steps. That specific style is so-called Taiwanese spirit, because it shows off Taiwanese vigor and humility. Therefore, we are sure if we can make fabulous shows to the world, that is, if our performances are enormously exposed to the world, it will be easier for us to let them know our culture eventually.
Thanks, Albert.
Let's take another experience as an example. That is, Youth Ambassador Taiwan ROC. The Ministry of Foreign Affairs of our countries has launched this program yearly since 2009. The elected representative of Youth Ambassador Taiwan ROC go overseas promoting cultural exchange. Every time, they will come and be loaded by the audience. This is the best way to prove that drama can talk and it works. With the help of cultural events presented to the world, people all over the world are deeply impressed by the energy and passion of our youth. Plus, their outstanding praise, beautiful songs, and vigorous dance with multiple costumes and properties increase Taiwan's diversity and freedoms. These events undoubtedly open up the image of Taiwan to the world.
Thanks, Jackie. The second solution is music. The second way of introducing Taiwan creatively is to take advantage of music. If we want to introduce something into Taiwanese folk song lyrics and sing along with the students after demonstrations of the songs, such famous Taiwanese folks, Si Ji Hong and Wang Chun Feng, that are melodic and catchy, we can lead these students to sing in an easy way, and everyone can get along well. Moreover, we can also achieve our goal, promoting Taiwanese touching voice to the world and strengthening the more wonderful impression on Taiwan. Even, we can use beatbox to accompany musically, integrating Western cultures they are familiar with to show our affinity to foreign students. That's for sure, this creative performance must promote Taiwan successfully while bringing the house down.
Thanks, Vivian. As the saying goes, music without borders. The magic of art is without borders, breaking through the limits and distance despite the language difficulties and the culture difference. Music, especially, is the easiest way of interpersonal communication and touching with one another. Thank you.